Test, eh? So normality test is very simple idea to make sure that the data is normally tabulated or not normally tabulated, so that we can proceed with the appropriate statistical measures or statistical tests that are suitable for our data. Eh? For example, you want to use the parametric test or non-parametric test. So based on our statistical measures explained by the normality test. So the first one, we need to identify first whether the data is normally tabulated or not normally tabulated. So we see first this theory. Around 5 minutes, and then after that we are going to proceed with the procedure, and hopefully you can get some ideas lah. So this is normality test. So there are two types of normality tests in the exploratory data analysis. The first one I'm going to explain about the Kolmogorov-Smirnov and Shapiro-Wilks. So Kolmogorov-Smirnov and Shapiro-Wilks is what we explained before lah. That you feel island kan, you rasa macam wow, what is this lah? I'm not sure what about this. So actually this thing is a very simple one. It's just to give you some idea about the whether your the adequacy of your data is normal or not normal, eh? It's very simple. And then you also need to see this based on the node is given to you that the alpha value must more than 0.05, then the data is normal lah. If your Shafiro and Kolmogorov are more than 0.05, then your data are considered normal. Beside that, you also can see the normal QQ plot and detrended normal QQ plot. So it can be considered under the detrended QQ plot when it is fall within the plus minus 0.1, eh? 0. This one got 0 lah here. You see here? Got 0, eh? 0.3. 0.3. Not 0.1. Sorry, 0.3. The skewness and kurtosis. The skewness and kurtosis is fall within the plus minus 1. Some idea of the researcher suggests also plus minus 2 also consider okay lah, eh? So this is the example of the skewness and also kurtosis. You can read for it. Okay? Now this is the way you want to interpret the data. So now, without further ado, let us analyze our data for normality test. Nak ke tak nak ni? You want to run our data, normality? Okay, open your data. So you want to run the Y, eh? Y is the output, or we call it as a job performance. We want to know the job performance is normally tabulated or not normally tabulated. It's very simple. You just go to the analyze. Dah go analyze lah. Okay, go to the analyze. Go to the descriptive statistic and choose the explore button. Explore. This one, explore. Okay, click the explore button. Okay, it will come radio button like this. Explore. Can you see it? Explore here. Okay, very good. Now put your job performance or Y only inside your dependent list. We just want to test the dependent list of the job performance first for our normality test. Eh? Put here inside the dependent list. Already put? Okay, very good. You just click statistic button here. And please check the button of M estimator and outlier. So this one is very important for us to identify any extreme values. Extreme values means that is abnormal data lah, abnormal data. Okay, I make a repetition. You just go to the statistic and then please click the M estimator and outlier. As default, the computer won't select it, but I want you to select it. Why? Because we want to identify the extreme values. Okay, already done? Very good. Go to the plots. Go to the plots and then please click the descriptive for the histogram. As default, the computer will select the stem and leaf, and then click another one will be the normality plot with test. The normality plot with test here will produce the Kolmogorov-Smirnov and Shapiro-Wilks statistic for you so that you can make interpretations. After that, click continue and then click option. You click option already? After that, click cancel lah. Option to just want to frank you lah, eh? Go to the bootstrap also and then click can. Click cancel. Just click there. Why? Just click. To make sure that your hand move around, eh? And then after that, click O. Okay. So after you click OK button, the SPSS will produce the statistical analysis like this. So we are going to interpret one by one. So the first thing that you need to understand is the descriptive table here. Okay, we got mean, 95% of confidence intervals. 5% stream mean, median, variance, standard deviation, minimum, maximum, range, interquartile range, skewness and kurtosis. So I'm going to share with you the ideas about how to know your data whether normal or not normal. So the first one, we look into the skewness. So how we want to interpret this thing is very simple. You take the skewness here, you divide by the standard error of the skewness. It's very simple. Okay? So this is our data, right? So our skewness will be 0.550 divided by 0.580. What you got here? Use your calculator. Oh, you don't have your calculator. If you don't have your calculator, you can borrow your friend. I don't understand Malay. Sorry. Cewa. Oh, ya, betul Mamat ni eh. Okay, 0.58. Saja je lah. So, this one you got around 0.948, correct? It's around to 0.95 lah. So, this one is within the plus minus 1 or not? It's within, right? Because this is our data, 0. So, this is our data, 1. This is minus 1. So, our data is 0.95. So, something around here, right? So, it's within our plus minus 1. So, we can consider this data are no? Andai, normal. So, beside that also, you also can consider, some researchers suggest plus minus 2. So, plus minus 2 means this one lah. You got, sorry. You got one line here. You got here 1. You got here minus 1. You got here 2. You got here minus 2. So, if within the plus minus 2 also can consider normal. So, by looking into the skewness, divide by the standard error of the skewness. Okay? Clear that one? That is the one trick. Another trick is a very simple one. You just take the standard error and then you times by 2. In this case, 0.580 times by 2, what you got? You got something to do with 1 point something, right? So, 1 point something is actually more than 0.5. Correct or not? So, if our standard error times by 2 is more than the statistic, then that's mean the data also normal. This one, kan? 0.58, you times by 2, you got 1 something, kan? So, this 1 something is more or not? More than our statistic, kan? So, this one also can consider no? Normal. That is how we want to identify the normality of data. So, based on this, our y is can be considered normal lah. So, you go down here. Excuse me. So, we have another one. We call it as the Kolmogorov-Smirnov. So, this one is a Kolmogorov-Smirnov. Kolmogorov-Smirnov. Okay? Kolmogorov-Smirnov. So, you can interpret based on the SIG value. So, the SIG value. So, if you identify the SIG value is more than 0.05, which is our alpha value, then we can declare this data as normal. Okay? This is a very, very basic one lah. For example, in this case, you got it 0.200, right? So, this one is more or less than 0.05. Okay, very good. It's more than 0.05. Therefore, we can consider this data as normally tabulated. Same also goes to the Shapiro-Wilks. If you find out the Shapiro-Wilks value, 0.572 is more than our 0.05, right? More than our alpha. Then, therefore, we justify this data as normally tabulated. Okay? So far, so good? Clear? So, the question is, why we use the Kolmogorov or Shapiro? When to use? When? How? Why they give two? So, actually, some researchers suggest that Kolmogorov-Smirnov are being used if your data is small sample. Small sample size, okay? Small sample size means that less than 30 sample. So, based on this, it's less than 30 lah because we only got 15, kan? So, Shapiro-Wilks, some of these researchers suggest more than 30 samples lah, higher sample size. But, of course, if you run for the big data set, this one will be significant. So, sometimes it's not really, really important to look into Kolmogorov. Faham tak? You can choose other indicator also. In my preference and in my professional opinion and experience, I believe in using the skewness and kurtosis because this one is much more sensitive, especially if your data is big enough. Eh? So this is the histogram. So you can double click to the histogram and then ask the computer to produce the histogram chart, histogram line like this. So you produce the line like this. So we can consider this line as normally tabulated lah. Okay, can you see it? Can you see it or not? This is the line. Okay, the line is being produced. So, how to produce the line? Okay, you click this one. You click this one, it will produce this one. Go to the chart editor and request this one. Request this. You see my cursor? My vibrate cursor there. Okay, click this one. It will produce for you and then close this box. Automatically, it will publish inside here. So, you want to copy and paste? Please be my guest. And then you can go down here to see the stem and leaf. Okay, as I mentioned to you before, stem and leaf are being considered to be interpreted as follows lah. You must look on the other side. Eh? You must telling your kepala. Eh? You move your head from this position. Okay, this is your head lah. You remove your head like this and then you can follow lah. So, if the data is something like this, tabulated nicely, we can consider this data is also normal. So, the next one, we are going to look into the detrended, normal QQ plot. So the normal QQ plot, how you want to interpret if the zero here, the circle here are fall within the line. So in this case, it almost fall within the line. So we can consider this one as the normally tabulated. Sometimes you can see your data tabulate like this, so it's not normal. Sometimes lah. So it depends on your data collection process. So based on this, we can say that okay, it's nice. So in terms of the figure for the QQ plot, we can suggest that this data is normally tabulated. Okay, the next one will be the detrended QQ plot. So the detrended QQ plot is very simple. You need to identify the data are within or not within the plus minus 0.3. Okay, this one is 0.3, right? Something around here. So this one is 0.3. So our data must follows within the plus minus 0.3. So far, this is our data. So we can consider this one is within lah, within. Dalam kita punya location plus minus 0.3. Faham tak? You got it or not? Very good. Okay, the next one. The last one but not least is the box plot. Okay, what you understand after you looking into this box plot? Okay, if you see here, number one and number two, this is what we call as the extreme values. What is this? Extreme values. So the number one and number two is your variable number or your ID number. So you can find the number one and number two, and please look it back whether it is so high or not. So based on our data, number one and number two indicate very high lah, 27 and 25, far beyond the other tabulated data. Nampak? Yang lain-lain semua less than 25. So this one is prominent enough lah to show high level of job performance. But in this case, we no need to alter or we no need to remove this extreme value. Why we don't want to remove? Because our data is normally tabulated, right? Our data is good. So, nothing to be harmful for us to just accept the data. Nah, except you must know lah, our data here got too extreme lah. Extreme means that is higher than the other normally tabulated and projected data in our data set lah. So, this is our data. Hopefully you can understand lah. So you run it already? Okay, now I want you to run again for the similar things for H. Try to run for H. Go to the analyze, discrete statistics, explore, job performance here, you replace with the H. We want to see the H whether it is tabulated normally or not. So you can just click OK button and change accordingly. And then you can see the data as follows. Then you can justify lah whether the data is normally tabulated or not. So based on this data, I would say that the data is normal or not normal. What do you think? What do you think about the data for H? The H is normal or not normal, ladies and gentlemen? Why you say like that? Why you say it's normal? Very good. The first one, we look into the skewness. The skewness here is 0.580 times by 2 is 1 point something, right? It's more than our statistic of the skewness. So that's mean our data is normally tabulated. Okay, the next one, we can find another evidence based on the Shapiro-Wilkes and also the Kolmogorov-Smirnov. So based on this, if we look into this, we can see the SIG value are more than our alpha. So therefore, we can suggest that this data is normally tabulated. Okay, the next one, we can find into the graphic element. So this histogram. So based on this histogram, of course, it's not so good lah. So we cannot say based on this histogram, it's a very nice shape. Not very nice lah kan? Nice or not nice? Boleh lah belah kan? So it's not very nice. So now we are going to choose the other parameters. So QQ plot also consider acceptable. Okay, this is detrended QQ plot. Fall within the 0.3 plus minus. Still fall and some of it are keceper lah. More than our required one. And then this is our box plot. The box plot also not indicate any extreme value. So far so good lah. So I can say that the H are normally distributed based on this analysis data. Okay, ladies and gentlemen.